If you've never been to Metro Places or seen a Metro Lagoon, get ready. We are going to take a look at one of the four lagoons they built around here in Florida. Actually, it's the only place you're going to find a Metro Lagoon in this country is right here in Florida. Let's get started. Welcome to our favorite YouTube channel where we talk about Florida, the Tampa Bay area, and living in the Tampa Bay area. If you are interested in any or all of these, you're going to want to click on that subscribe button down below. Hit that notification button as well. We will let you know when our next video is published, which should be next Thursday. Hi, my name is Mike LaBoy. I'm a realtor with Dalton Wade Real Estate here in the beautiful Tampa Bay area. My wife Paula and I have lived in the Tampa area for better than 30 years, and we absolutely love living here. Among other things, we really enjoy helping people with what is probably the largest single transaction they're ever going to make, buying or selling a home. Have questions about real estate in the Tampa area? In the comment section down below, there's a link to schedule a telephone call with me. You can make that a Zoom call if you'd like to. Paul and I really enjoy making these videos. We want to make sure there's something that our adoring public, you, are going to want to watch. If you have a suggestion about a topic related to real estate, living in Florida, living in Tampa Bay, we would like to know. There's a link down below that will you can send us a request. And yes, we do take requests. Let us know what you want to know. We'll try to make that happen. In this video, we are using one of those suggestions from B. Wallace. We're going to take a look at Mirada by Metro Places. For decades, developers have been building communities around a golf course, pretty much all over the southern part of the United States. Texas, Arizona, Florida, you know, the big retirement states have seen more of these golf communities go up than probably any other state in the country, which is great if you play golf. According to the National Golf Foundation, about 8% of the total population of the United States plays golf. I mean, 8%, that's it? It's not a retirement community, but Paul and I live in a golf course community. It's great for me, I play golf. Paula, on the other hand, thinks it's pretty dumb to chase a little white ball around the park. I would imagine most of the households that live in a golf course community are pretty much like ours. One person plays golf, the spouse and probably the kids, not so much. What happens, if it's possible, the family does not join the golf club and pay monthly dues, so the club is dependent upon daily players to play and to, you know, stay in business. Well, as it turns out, golf courses are very expensive to build and maintain. I mean, they take a lot of acreage, like 150 or so acres. Just maintaining a golf course can cost upwards of $1 million a year. In Florida, well, there's a golf course that seems like every 5 miles, so those daily players have a lot of choices. Getting regular cash flow from them is difficult for any golf course. They can and have gone out of business. So owning a home on a golf course that has filed bankruptcy and was sold to a developer is not what you pay extra money to live in a golf course for, and it has happened like at Quail Hollow and Pebble Creek. There are a lot of unhappy homeowners out there. Enter Metro Places. Their concept is to use the same quality builders but build around a lagoon. No, it's not the Black Lagoon. It's a resort lagoon, something like you might find in Cancun, Cozumel, the Fiji Islands, you know, white sandy beaches, clear blue water, tiki huts, restaurants, water sports. I mean, what a novel idea. Something for the entire family right in your neighborhood. So, you know, Dad can go play golf and the rest of the family can go to the beach and it's maybe 2 blocks away. Metro Places has developed several communities across the country with 12 of them right here in the Tampa Bay area. They have built several lagoon neighborhoods in places like Chile, Panama, Egypt, Dubai. A couple of years ago, they started Epperson Ranch out in Wesley Chapel. There's a link to our video on Epperson Ranch in the comment section down below. Watch it later. Epperson was the first of four planned lagoon communities in Florida. As a matter of fact, it was the first in the country. That 7-acre freshwater lagoon has been open for about a year, just a little over a year now, and it's actually pretty cool. The lagoon is basically a large pool. It's about 11 million gallons of water. Compare that to my pool, which is about, I think, 23,000 gallons of water. Homes have been selling for almost 2 years, and most of the first phase is already sold out. The second phase, just north of that, has started, they started building there. South Shore Bay, over in Waimama, is the only lagoon community in Hillsborough County. It has a 5-acre lagoon. It was just opened up to residents only for a limited time. But they're selling a ton of houses, so if you could be a resident, pretty quick. Brightwater will be in North Fort Myers with a 5-acre lagoon and has an expected completion date of, I think it's the spring of 2022. They are also currently selling homes. The fourth lagoon community in Florida is just north of Tampa in San Antonio. Santa Ann, which is what locals call it, is located in east central Pasco County, about on Highway 52, about, I don't know, 30, 35 minutes north of downtown Tampa. Santa Ann itself is a pretty small little city. Its population, I think, is like 1,400 people. That's about to change. They've gone even so far as to put up their own public supermarket, and that's just getting started. Highway 52 is being expanded to four lanes, both east and west of I-75. The I-75-52 intersection was reworked a couple years ago in anticipation of future growth. So getting to Tampa is gonna be about a 30-minute ride, depending on time of day and how many accidents there are. Tampa International Airport is a solid 45 minutes, 60 if you decide to make a trip during rush hour. You're gonna have to go right through downtown Tampa to get there. Things to do around Santa Ann vary and include just about every outdoor activity you could want all year round, which is why people live in Florida. I can play golf pretty much all year round. One of the big attractions in the area is Lake Jobita. It is a beautiful lake with clear blue water. On the east side of the lake is the gated community of Lake Jobita Golf and Country Club. It has two 18-hole golf courses that actually have an elevation. And if you play golf in Florida long enough, you're gonna understand what I'm talking about. On the west side of the lake is the pier and park. It's offering kayaking, paddleboarding, fishing, and a couple barbecue grills and some picnic tables. There are no motorboats allowed, so it's pretty nice and quiet. Other than golfing at Lake Jobita, you can choose the Tampa Bay Golf and Country Club, which is about 8 or 9 miles west. Hernando Oaks Golf Club, it's about 30 minutes away, as is Southern Hills and Brooksville Country Club. For those hikers and bikers, no, not those kind of bikers. There are several preserves, wildlife management areas, and literally, I mean, hundreds of miles of trails. For those types of bikers, the area has roads with real curves, hills that aren't just overpasses over I-75, and restaurants dotted all over the area. There are things like Snowcat Ridge, Florida's only tubing and ice skating place. I mean, really, have a birthday party in an igloo in Florida with the snow. I mean, what's the world coming to? Some of our favorite places to eat are right there in San Antonio. There's Poncho Villa Mexican Restaurant, Al's Pizza Shop, which is really good pizza, On Q Smokehouse, and yes, we really do drive from Lutz to Santa Ann for dinner. More than likely, we're on the Harley going for lunch, but we do like to eat there. About 20 minutes south of San Antonio is the Wiregrass area. If you've never been to the Wiregrass area, you are missing out. There are more restaurants, pubs, barbecue places, movie theaters, and just about any type of car dealership you're ever gonna want. Shopping can be had at hundreds of small independent stores. And you've got the Wiregrass Mall. Tampa Premium Outlet Mall, and the Groves. The amount of shopping over there is just, I mean, it's ridiculous. They even have a Costco and a Sam's Warehouse. One of the best parts of the west coast of Florida is the beaches. From San Antonio, you're looking at an hour, hour and a half, maybe longer to get to Clearwater Beach, except when you're in Mirada. Mirada by Metro Places has just started development, with homes starting in the mid 200,000s to the getting into the upper $700,000 range. Currently, the builders are D.R. Horton Homes and Villas, LGI Homes, and Mirada Homes. Late 2022, Biscayne Homes is going to start building, and those homes will be in the low $1 million price range. The lagoon at Mirada is going to be the largest of the four around Tampa area, with 15 acres of clear blue water. If it's anything like the others, it's going to be a pretty cool place to hang out, go for a swim, have dinner or a drink at the Tiki Hut, swim in the beautiful fresh blue water, just lounge on the beach and get a cabana and spend the day. The parts you don't see at Mirada and all the Metro Places areas is actually in the ground. Metro Places has developed and successfully launched what they call the Connected City. It's pre-wired underground for the fastest Wi-Fi they call UltraFi, where you can get speeds up to 1 gigabyte anywhere. So no matter where you are in the community, you're going to be connected to the fastest Wi-Fi possible. That technology sets the framework for the Connected City with its smart homes and smart businesses. The system also lets you connect to hospitals, libraries, commerce, and the state-of-the-art K-8 free charter schools called Innovation Preparatory Academy. Amenities you find at Mirada are typical of all Metro Place communities. Leave the car at home, take your golf cart on the designated cart paths, go out on the miles of nature paths, bike paths, or just take a walk. Maybe even do that exercise thing and jog. They are known for leaving plenty of green space, also known as parks, shaded tot lots for the kids, and for your four-legged members, there are dog parks. For someone who wants to get out of the congestion around the city of Tampa, Santa Ana is going to be a solid option. It is in the country, but it's not far away. Give us a call if you have any questions or need some more information. We love to talk about real estate, especially around the Tampa Bay area. If you haven't already done it, take a second, click on the subscribe button down below. It's the red one. Push the notification button as well. Thanks for watching. Go out and make it a great day.